Hey guys, it's Dan here from PixelFix and welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to talk about Laravel's one-to-many relationship, and in our example we'll be setting up roles for our user accounts. Alright, so let's start off by creating our role model. And we want a factory and a migration. Alright, so if we look at our role migration, we want to add some fields to the table, and we'll just add one field and we'll call it name, because we only want to give our role a name at this stage. And we also want to add the role ID to the users table so we can set up our relationships. So what we'll do is we'll add a foreign ID called role ID, and we will also chain on our constraint method. All right, now we can rerun our migration by calling php artisan migrate fresh. All right, so if we look at the error, it says that it failed to open the reference table roles. Okay, now this is because we've added the constraint method on the role ID. So in this case, what we'll do is we'll just remove this. It's just because it runs the create users table first before the roles table actually exists. That's why it cannot add this column. So what we'll do is we'll just remove that. We'll make a separate migration after the roles table is created, and then we'll add our role ID column to the users table. So let's make a new migration. Got PHP artisan make migration, and we'll say add role ID column to users table. And we'll reference the table users. All right, so now we've got a brand new migration and we can do the same thing. So we'll add a table for an ID called role ID, and we can chain on the constraint method. So now if we rerun our migration using PHP artisan migrate fresh, it should work beautifully. Okay, so let's set up our relationships. Let's head over to our role model. And in our role model, we will create a new public function called users. Okay, so if you think about the one-to-many relationship, in PHP programming, any parent class can have multiple child classes, but a child class can only have one parent class. The same goes for relationships. So an easy way I think about it is if I look at the table. So let's look at the users table, for instance. If the primary key of a table is present in the table you're looking at, meaning that the role ID is present in the users table, that would make the users the child and the role would then be the parent. So in order for us to set up the relationship in the role model, we'll return the relationship on users to this has many, and it has many children, and the child would be the user class. Okay, now to set up the inverse of this, we will go to the user model. And we'll add a public function called role, because we use the singular word role because a user can only have one role at a time. And then we will return the relationship of this. And what does this do? What is the user? The user belongs to a role because the role is the parent class or parent relationship in this case. Okay, so let's quickly set up our seeder so we can populate the database with some roles. We'll just use the default database seeder, and we will call the role factory. Do we want to create, let's say we want to create an entry of administrator. And we also want to create one for user. All right, so let's also set up a factory to create some users. And let's say we want to create 10 users, and then we call the create function. Now we just need to make sure that our user factory has been set up properly. All right, so the only thing we need to add is our role ID column, and for our role ID we'll just call the random method to randomize between 1 and 2, because the roles we set up will have IDs 1 and 2 respectively. And now we can rerun our database migration and it will seed our users as well. Okay. All right, so let's quickly set up a roles endpoint to see this in action. In order for us to do that, we'll need a controller called role controller. And we also need a resource to do this properly. Okay, and let's set up our route. All right, so it will be route. And we'll call our role controller. And we'll just call the index method for now. So we'll say the name of our route would be roles.index. We also need a role collection. That is because we're going to return, because we use the index method, we're going to return a collection of role resources. So that's why we'll need a role collection. So we do that by calling php artisan make resource. And we call it role collection. And then in order to create a collection, we need to pass the collection flag. And now you can see the resource collection was created successfully. All right, now we can set up our index route in our controller. So we call, make it a public function, index. And what we want to return is a new role collection. And what we want to pass in is the roles. We'll just say we're going to return all the roles for now. All right, so let's head over to Postman to see this in action. All right, so if we call our route, we should get a list of all our roles. These are the roles we set up earlier using the seeder. All right, so now let's customize our role resource in order for us to see which users are assigned to which role when we visit this endpoint. So let's head back out to VS Code. Okay, so in our role resource, let's customize the fields that are being returned. Okay, so the fields we want to return is the ID field, and we'll call this .id. We also want to return the name of the role, which would be this .name. Now we also want to return the users. Now in order to return the users, we'll just be able to call this .users, because we've set up the users as a relationship. All right, so let's save this, head back over to Postman, and let's refresh. Great, now we get our list of roles, and then we get a list of, or collection of users that's got that role currently assigned. Now, as you can see, all the users will return all the fields, but we don't necessarily want to do that. So if we head back over to VS Code, we look at our user resource, which we already have, it only returns the ID, the name, and the email field. Now, in order for us to utilize this resource in our role resource, we'll need to set up a collection, a user collection. So let's create a new collection. Let's be artisan make resource. And now we're going to create a user collection. And we're going to pass in the collection flag. Now, if we head back over to our role resource, what we now can do is, because this returns a collection, we can basically wrap this in a new user collection. And now we will only return the fields specified in the user resource. Let's head back over to Postman and let's refresh. And there we go. We've got our list of roles again. And now for each user, it's only returning the fields specified in the user resource. All right, so just to recap, today we looked at a one-to-many relationship and how to set that up. The easiest way for me to think about it is, if the table or model I'm looking at references the primary key of the other table or other model, then that table would be the child, because the child references the ID of the parent. So in our case, the user's table or the user's model references the role ID. So that meaning that it makes the user the child and the role the parent. So then in the child, you use the relationship method called belongs to. And then in your role, you would say that role has many users. Thank you so much for watching, guys. I really hope this was informative, and I really hope I explained it well. I really would appreciate any feedback on how I'm performing, and if there's anything you would want me to do specifically, or if you have any kind of feedback, I really appreciate it. So please leave it down in the comments. And yes, thank you again. I'll see you in the next episode. Cheers.